34, still somebody has to join. Wait for a few minutes. Yeah, 47. Okay. Nivedita, just mute for this one.
Yes, sir. Yes.
So total, how many are there in our section? 58 or 59? These sections total stand?
60, sir.
60. Okay, still 9 more. I think how many are joined in the previous class? Topic.
57.
57. Sangram Patra, just mute your this one.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Rehan, there are two accounts. There is another account from my name, Rehan. I think kindly put your name only. Don't put any other your friend's name. I think while joining, that will be easy. Okay, let them, others can join. Now we will start. So I think we are last class we have been discussing about bioheuristic planning. Yeah, Sangram Patra. Yes. Santosh, you can mute. 51. I think very good afternoon, friends. I think today we will going to. I think last class we have been discussing about bioheuristic planning. Now today we will going to know about the special types of garden. As you know, garden is the garden for the home and other things. In the garden itself, there is a special types of garden that I'm going to share with you now. Okay. The special types of garden. Yeah. I think there are several special types of gardens are there, like roof garden, sunken garden, vertical garden, terrace garden, water garden, bog garden, shade garden, okay, rock garden, terrariums, bottle or dish garden, then window garden, island. There are several types are there. We will deal. I think very simple concept. This garden is already, you know, what are the types of features should be there and other things. So now we're going to deal with the special types of gardens. I think first will be, these are the special types gardens we are going to undergo. Just will envisage the few things about this garden. Okay, shortly we're going to tell what roof garden are we going to do, what are the plants suitable for that, all those things. Okay, first we will go to the roof garden. The the garden on the flat roof of a building, especially one found in urban setting or urban cities, is called as the roof garden. I think you might know in the Bangalore cities, in the apartment, it doesn't find a place to construct a garden in front of your house. So that's why if your house and the above, I think there is no space for the horizontal, only vertical space is available. Or in the rooftop, you can do that. The garden on the flat roof of a building, especially one found on in urban setting, is called as a roof garden. Often there is a misconception in India between roof garden and terrace garden. Okay, so one are the same, but I think terrace gardening where you are facing for the utility purpose also, you can grow the vegetables also. Here it is only for the roof garden, especially for the recreation or the aesthetic value. In many publications, the gardening on the roof is often termed as a terrace gardening, which is not strictly correct according to the British concept. Okay. In modern times, individual homes with a compound and a lawn are becoming a rare in cities and towns, and skyscrapers are replacing such homes. I think if you might have heard that in Bangalore, Mumbai, or maybe in a very other metros like Singapore, we never find any the gardens in front of our house. Only the buildings like the size skyscrapers are there. So in that we are doing it. So that's why now I think the popularity has been increasing for the roof garden. As a result, private home gardens are vanishing, and the only places left for gardening are in the roofs of the house. What I mean to say is, I think if you go to Mumbai streets, you never find an ample space in front of your house because of road extension or maybe a limited space. Only it has been constructed only a house gate and other things. So that's why you can only space if you want to enjoy the garden, you can get it from the especially rooftops of the houses. A spacious, well-planned roof garden can be a place of joy and recreation. In bigger cities of India, many of the large hotels, public buildings are developing this type of gardens. Roof garden setting, now they are popular. I think if you go to the Bangalore, Sarandi, I think earlier, you know, restaurants are in the ground floor only. Now, in earlier cases, now it has been shifted to the rooftop gardens or the rooftop restaurants. Like that, the gardens are very popular in the large hotels and public buildings. I think if you are staying in a star hotel, where you can get the restaurant or the eating area is in the rooftop along with the garden. That's why they are very popular. Okay, I think the roof garden, there will be basically two types, extensive and intensive. Okay, based on the amount of maintenance required, the depth of soil and types of plants the area will support, the rooftop can classify into three basic types. Okay, one is extensive living groups or the extensive roof gardens or the living roof gardens, semi-extensive living roof gardens, or the intensive living groups or the intensive roof gardens. I think coming to the extensive roof gardens range from the soil depth, it is very shallow, like 2.5 to 12.5 centimeter maximum of a feet or 3 to 15 centimeter soil depth. Semi-extensive living groups have deeper soils. It is intensive means where I think more than 1 foot soil is there. But semi-extensive is in between that. Semi-extensive living groups have deeper soils and can therefore support a greater number and wide variety of plants, making them more decorative. However, their depth makes them heavy, so they require strong structure to support them. I think we are constructing a gardens in the roof level, that you have to have the supporting system. I think if the load on the rooftop, it's also detrimental for the early dangers for the rooftop. Okay, that may also the fall. That's why very important, based on that requirement and strength of your rooftop, you can construct the gardens. That's however, the depth makes them heavy, so they require strong structure to support them. They can combine the relatively low maintenance of extension roofs with a more aesthetic appearance. Okay, that means I prefer or suggest you to go for the extensive roof garden. That means very shallow, like 2.5 to 12.5 centimeter soil depth is there, where you can plant the, it is never heavy for the rooftop and it will be sustainable is there. So that's why the intensive living groups require a minimum 1 foot of a soil depth to create a more traditional roof garden with a large tree, shrubs and other maintained landscapes. They require intensive maintenance also. What I mean to say, intensive is, I think if you want to have a very good, the small trees or maybe shrubs, just like a natural one in the water, which is there in the the ground garden, that has to be there in the intensive. The soil depth is more, and the rooftop capacity holding is also very, it should be very strong. That's why I think these are the three: intensive, extensive, then semi-extensive. All, I think, basically two types, but in between also you can make the in between these two, intensive and to accommodate more plants and which it can sustain and may create the aesthetic value. Besides above three, even I think these are the basic basic three types. So besides that, there will be a different, I think nowadays a recent concept, in recent days there are several roof gardens are being designed. I think you know, just communal roof gardens. What are the green roofs can be sloped down to a ground level to make them accessible to the pedestrians. This roof design used for in spa hotels, an unusual protected environment. It could be used for campus type environment, business parks, universities. These are like communal, I think, where I think the green roofs can slope down to the ground level. I think just, you know, slope down and touch to the ground level, where you can develop the roof gardens can be developed. In public roof parks, a green bridge can be used to join the green roofs on separate buildings. I think if the construct apartments is there, like one builder, like Godrej or maybe Prestige apartment one by one. So in a group of apartments, where you can make the bridge among them. In the rooftop, you can connect the individual apartments. In the rooftop, you're making a bridge and you can connect to a different roof gardens. That's like a public roof park. It depends on the people or the constructor, where you can, the green bridge can be used to join the green roofs on separate building, thus creating a continuous public and private green space at roof level. This green space planning is ideas described elsewhere in the Skywalk. I think if you go to the constructor or the apartment owner, is like Prestige Group, Group 1, the apartment 1 or the segment 1, segment 2, 3, 4, in a particular area, if they make 10 or 15, then you can make the roof gardens, and they're both the segments or the different apartments interconnected by a green bridge, just like a Skywalk, a Skyway. So that means you can make, I think, whatever the gardens you are going to see in the ground, it can be utilized in the rooftop. That's why it's called a public roof parks. I think these are, this type of gardens are, I think they are in Singapore, Hong Kong. I think there, I think most of them are having this type of public roof parks. Just like public parks in our ground level, there has been the apartments, they're going to have the public roof park. Next, nature conservation roofs. This is often more appropriate to use vegetated roofs as a wildlife habitat than amenity in a green roof for people. I think this is will be in the forest, where I think nature conservation roofs or the roof garden. It is often appropriate to use vegetated roofs as a wildlife habitat than the amenity for the green roof. So I think it is for the, those, I think, small forest animals can, they can dwell there, use the rooftop as a, their nest or the home for that. Then private roof gardens. Roofs are designed as a living space and have been made since ancient times. Unlike the roof garden types described below, the private roof gardens benefit from the surrounding wall, at least to waist height, to safety, and to overhead shelter or pergola, provide a special security and shade required. I think these are, I think days to come, these are the, some of the, other than the natural one, whatever the types I told, these are the common roof gardens which are going to exist. Already they are in there, elsewhere, not in India. Like, I think public roof parks or the nature conservation roof, it is there in other countries, in the developed nations, where they are going to make the, for the aesthetic purpose as well as the, to the limited space in the ground level, they are exploiting for the rooftops or the building or the house. Now, how should be like, you know? Just I think how the design, I think if at all, if you decide want to roof garden, what exactly design should be there, style should be there, and how go about with that. Roof garden needs a careful planning and design. That's most important. I think, sir, I am, my terrace is there, sir, my, especially first floor we are staying, and above that there is a rooftop is there, can create. That's why based on the careful planning and designing, that these are the essential requirements are there, where you can take up the roof garden. First, I think foremost important is, I think whatever the rooftop is there, that should be waterproof layer, should be the base layer, which is added to the existing surface, should be waterproof layer. Okay, then above that, roof membrane. Waterproofing layers such as asphalt and bitumen are very susceptible to damage to the plant roofs. Okay, whatever I think asphalt they're doing now, they are also very easy to damage with the plant roof. They can penetrate and they meet to leaks also. That's why roof member should be the leak proof, or maybe a pond liner of a butyl lining or a 300 micron damp proof polythene should be laid over the waterproof. I think in the rooftop, whatever the waterproof you are making, above that you have to make the line there on 300 micron damp proof polythene sheet. That means there is no percolation of water, and even there is no penetration of the roots, I think roots also. Okay, then you have to make a filter sheet. This is the, this sheet allows the moisture to drain from the roof but retains the fine materials. Okay, I think I will show you detail in picture what exactly layer should be there. Filter sheet, this filter sheet allows the moisture to drain off and the roof but retains the fine material. Okay, then drainage layer, this helps to retain the moisture while allowing excess water to be drained away. The commercial system store water and make plastic or a geotextile materials. I think this is very important. I think the where I think you cannot able to take water to the, I think there will be a water taps or the syntax will be there. But even then, whatever the heavy rain downpour is there, but our structure should not be disturbed. Like it should not leak to the roof or else should not be go away. So that's why these are the layers, waterproof layer. Then you have to make the roof or membrane, that is plastic sheet, and also filter sheet, whatever excess, and drainage there. Once the drainage is there, you can collect them and you can collect somewhere and you can put it or recycle for the again for maintenance of the roof guard. I think whatever the, once you make these designs, what are the soils and substrates are required? That's the most important. I think we are making, I think first floor is okay, the strength rooftop is okay. If you are conducting at a very, I think that's the pillar should stay, bear the strength also. If you are going to 10th floor or 11th floor, then what type of substrate or the soil is required? The top layer, the growing media, should be light and free, and free draining it of material that retains the moisture. I think it easily drain out the moisture, and also it have a capacity to hold some moisture. Then only it can give to the plants for thriving. Okay. Then I think the planting and caring is most important. Use, I think this is the most important point you can say. Use lightweight soil, soilless mixtures or the mixers or the partial mixes for the containers. I think as much as possible you can make the just like, you know, small lawn and other things, very shallow deep, like 7 to 8, 10 centimeter, and even use the whatever it is the material. If you want to make the you can use a lightweight material or the lightweight soilless mixtures, and also to choose the drought tolerant plants that will tolerate the rooftop and also balcony conditions. Okay, then daily watering with an easy maintenance, drip irrigation system or mulching. Somehow I think this is the most important. Most of the people won't prefer the first floor or the second floor because always I think some age olds cannot able to climb on the rooftop and to take care. The same way, the maintenance should be easy, or the watering, I think you can, what's Rehan, what is your problem? Rehan. Yeah, Rehan, tell me. Okay, use lightweight soilless mixture for the containers. Okay, choose drought tolerant plants that will tolerate rooftop or balcony conditions, and daily watering with an easy maintenance. You can make a drip irrigation. Now I think very easy now. There are several automated irrigation systems are came that you can make a drip line and you can water it in the, just with the mobile Android app, you can water it. How much? The sensors also, they came now. What is the soil, the moisture requirement? Just I think that will give, I think whenever they irrigate, you can irrigate it by yourself. You need not to go to the rooftop. You need not be like rooftop, even if there in other places also. I think if, when you are in a indoor gardening you are making, you, there is irrigation system which came with Israel or the drip irrigation water. I think now it's available where the sensors are involved. I think once the water deficit is there, it will going to give alarm or it will give a message. So your water needs, your plants, indoor plants needs or the required water. So if you are go out of the station or you are maybe in a vacation, so you are, I think you are staying in Bagalkot, then you can irrigate through with this automated irrigation system. Okay, then use water soluble and low slow release fertilizer. This is also most important. I think for effectiveness of the growth of the plant, water soluble fertilizers can be, and also those that are releasing slow. I think these are the plants for the roof garden. I think unlike, I will show you picture now after this. Climber, not like ficus repens. I think nowadays most of them are ficus repens. They have been avoiding because it's going to penetrate the wall also. Veronia, Eliginifolia, Sunbergia alata, flowering onions. I think you can rooftop, you can make them. Someone is making noise. Rehan. Okay.
Sir, it's not me, sir. Somebody else is like.
Yeah, I will. Okay. I will find out. Yeah, flowering is like antirrhinum, stalks, dwarf sweet peas, pansy, dahlia, chrysanthemum, marigold, sweet alyssum, phlox, verbena. All these things will be planted flowering as herbaceous perennials like pelargonium, canna, parsulaca, goldenrod, periwinkle. And you can use this. I think you have to rejoin again after 10 minutes. Need not to worry. Herbaceous perennials. And even you can use the small like bonsai trees also, say Fluberia, then Calyptus lanceolate, that is a bottle brush, then Glericidia.
कौन सूत रहा है? सोया था मैं रात भर.
Basically, इसको बोला साफ हो जाएगी. पूरा हाथ हम साफ
करना. Wow, who is making noise? अरे
पुलिस आता है क्या वो? पकड़ लिया ना.
Then Plumeria, then Glericidia, Araucaria cookie, the Mumus Elange Brassica, all this can be done. That I think just I will. Yeah, I think, you know, as I told, while constructing a roof garden, this is the plan. The roof deck is there. Then you have to make a waterproofing membrane. Above that, there will be a insulation. Then root barrier. I think roots are very clever. They can penetrate to a deeper layer also. That should be the root barrier. That will protect against the roots. They should not penetrate. Okay, then protection fabric. This is the drainage layer. Whatever the excess metal will drain and it will going to collect and you can reuse them. Then after the above that drainage layer, there will be a filter layer. Okay. Then above that you are going to add the growing media and that you are going to plant the vegetation. Okay. This is the typical the steps involved in establishment of the root garden. I think this is the root deck. Then you have to make the above that you have to make a waterproof membrane and above that you can make insulate material. Then root barrier. Then protection fabric. Drainage layer, then filter layer, and growing media. Above that, you are going to do this. Yeah, this is I think typical roof garden where I think unlike it is, you can make this whatever it is a lawn or maybe garden benches. You can see that very. I think this is also intensive. I think more than 1 feet soil has been deposited here. You can make the garden like just like you know the gardens, then shrubbery. Okay, this is the balcony where I think they can utilize this. Use that. Now coming to the, I think remaining are very simple. Sunken garden. It is formed taking advantage of natural depression. I think if you are well, I think as I told, while selection of site, you have to utilize the, analyze the existing site. Where undulations is there, where mound is there, you can make the carpet or mound layers. Or if it is sunken area, or the low lying area is there, or natural depression is there, it is in place for the development of the garden. It is formed taking an advantage of natural depression. The depression is made into different tiers over which ground covers, edges, flower beds, or small arms may be grown. At the center of the depression, a pond or a pool may be formed to grow the water plants. Sunken garden can be laid out in already existing depression of a land or a portion of the garden may be modified to a layout such garden. Since sunken ground is likely to collect water. So as is the low-lying area is there is a lot of chance of when heavy rainfall is there is a lot of water collection there. So that's why you have to make the adequate drainage arrangement should be made. This is the simplest method will have to have one or two drainage outlets and connect them to a sewage system. It is not advisable to have a sunken garden in a very heavy soil. Okay, in heavy soil should not have, because in heavy soil there is a drainage problem. The garden is likely to flood it rapidly. The special arrangement should be made or to be taken care to make to drain out the excess water which has accumulated over a period of time. Some drainage materials such as stone, rubble, etc. Who is that making that noise?
It's a virus. Study getting shut down, affects the business. Gets another meeting. Time to watch Netflix. Start up
your phone. I don't know.
Who is this fellow?
क्या तो कर रहा हूँ? ओह काम लगा रहा
है। रहान।
सर, यस सर।
तेरे टू रहान सर दे रहा है। Who is that Rehan?
Yeah. I don't know the other Rehan. Who is he, sir? He is causing the nuisance.
Oh, he is went now. He is went now. He is logged out. I think I will lock this room. That will be better. No one can join. Yeah, 51 center. I think now we can't. He can't able to do that. Yeah, sunken garden, as I told, sufficient. I think natural depression is there. You can do that. Some drainage materials such as stones, pebbles may be replaced below the surface of the sunken garden at a depth of about 1 meter from the surface. The thickness of these materials may be around 60 centimeter. Steps should be taken to prevent the surface runoff water falling into the sunken garden. I think I will show you that the sunken garden the pictures also is going to an idea. Okay. I think whatever the natural depressions are there, you can see whatever the natural depressions they made into a just like a sit out. In that they made a pond. It is just like, you know, sunken garden. This is also like natural depressions in the valley. They constructed in typically in that. The best example is our Rashtrapati. I think this is serves as a both purpose. It is also circular garden as well as the sunken garden. I think natural depression they used as a. I think you can see the Kenningston garden. It is also sunken. This is also a depression has been made a terraces like sunken. Yeah, coming to the vertical garden, I think this might have been seen nowadays is a recent trend like vertical garden or the green wall. Vertical gardening involves the gardening with upright structure so as to utilize the vertical space. It is ideal for the gardening in urban city areas and apartments with the balconies. Many structures including fences, arbors, trellis and walls can be used to create a vertical garden. Hanging plants and the pulley systems can be used to make vertical gardening attractive. I think this is the most important. I think you can see that. I think these are the where a lot of the space is utilized for the vertical garden. Sharing, testing. Yeah, I think this you might have seen that. These are the gardens. Yeah, in the office premises you might have seen that these are the in the office walls they have been constructed in. These vertical gardens, or else it's called as also called as the green walls. Okay, these are the things. I think these are the structures they're going to erect, and they can parts can be hanged on there. There also a lot of maintenance is important. Now, I think in apartments where the space is constrained, those who still they want to have the garden that can be utilizing these vertical space around the walls or in the balconies, they can do that. I think in another one point, I think one minute will go to. You're going to end the meeting and you can rejoin that. We will continue that this one. Okay. After that, you can rejoin. No problem. Vertical gardens of recent trends. I think with the limited space now, I think in this type of parts also available. You can do that. Okay. All the walls, whatever it is that decorated the planting materials or the hanging parts they are going to do that. Yeah, I think terrace garden. I think, as I told, it is an in line with the roof garden, but it is a utilitarian point of view. Or whatever, if the garden is arranged in various levels of terraces, okay, the terrace gardening involves land raising and construction of steps, ramps, okay, walls, just like, you know, terrace farming. Like that, you can, in the garden itself, you can make the terrace gardening, like steps, ramps, walls, paved paths, as well as the planting lawn grasses and other plants. It is desirable to have the plants on the terrace, but it should be restricted to the edge of the edge so that middle is left open for the circulation. Since such